text, the film, you know, While My Face Might Be On, it's the culmination of a great deal of work coming from many different sources. And it wouldn't be what it is without the community that has been so supportive of this. You know, the first Zeitgeist was not actually a film. Some might know this, that know the history. It was just a personal project. And the only reason I'm here is because of all of you. The only reason I've continued to do this, because I don't particularly enjoy filmmaking, I'm perfectly honest. But I appreciate what it amounts to being in the communication and the role it serves in society as an art form, the change that it can have as an effect. And that's the most important point. So I don't sit here as a filmmaker of the product that I've made. I stand here as an activist and somebody that's trying to, as an artivist, yes. Good plug. But you know, this is a medium that's a powerful medium that has a tremendous effect on culture. You know, media, I think, has more of an effect on the way people think. Obviously, it does, in fact, than any type of, you know, basic philosophy or interests of an individual or even a government policy or politics in general. The value systems of society are shaped by the media more than anything else. And I'm hoping that this type of contribution and what will come out of it will be positive. Obviously, I'm not, by the way, as a brief disclaimer for all the people that are going to publish this in the reviews, I'm not calling for everyone to pull all their money out of banks and on the streets of central banks, as beautiful as that might be. But hence the nature of the quote at the very beginning. But I know some reviewers are going to go crazy with this, with sort of counterculture. What it might imply, as you might have heard in the media, there's some strange implications with my films already. But nevertheless, I really appreciate you guys being here, and I'll answer questions.
Well, actually, I have a lot of questions, but before I even begin, I just want to say that being here today with all of you, I hope you understand that this is the dawn of a new day.
Yeah.
This passion, this purpose, this idea for a resource-based society and global abundance is not something that our children will inherit. It's something that we get to create and we get to inherit in this lifetime. That's how possible this is. That's how possible this is. And we were talking a few months ago, and we actually talked about that, how quick would it take to create this world? And I told you, in the blink of an eye.
In a sense, absolutely. It's an awareness issue. As Jacques pleaded with the world in the 1970s and through his whole life, you know, we have the technical capacities to do tremendous things. It's the ideological structures that hold it. And people holding on to this system because of their self-identification, of course. To comment on the nature of power and the addiction of power, which was so important and so eloquently pointed out by Dr. Gabor Mate, and that's really, it's a very important thing to consider, that the sickness that we see in culture that we think is human nature and such as these processes of dopamine-related addictions, people get these addictions to power, they want more and more, it's beyond all rationale, and that's really what rules the world today, is that form of addiction, and it's rewarded, and it's a sickness, but that is really what stops everything that moves in sort of a progressive sense is these associations, the mind lock is set, the culture, the status quo is created, and anything that goes against it is hit with a tremendous backlash because it's not only interfering with the power establishment and their interworkings, you know, but it's also interfering with the social identification, the identities of the individuals that really want to believe that the world we live in is in support of them. And unfortunately, this paradigm is an anti-human paradigm. Hopefully, it's a process of evolution, too. We could change the face of the Earth in 10 years, as Jacques said. If there was an interest to do so, you could do it immediately, if you really wanted to do it. So people can say, oh, this will never happen. The reason they say that is because they understand the value problems. They say, well, there's too many, it's too complex, you know, there's too many people, there's how you orient the technicals of the property issue and getting the resources from the corporations. Obviously, it would take an initiative to get the corporations to understand that it's in their self-interest as human beings to begin this type of process, begin this type of organization, and responsible management of society and taking account for human well-being, and not just eating and drinking. of the nature of what we need as human beings, of what gives us, what enables us to be prosperous, not be neurotic, not develop addictions, and all those things that people might wonder, some have already asked me, and a lot of the first session didn't make sense to me. Like, well, you're missing something very, very important. Is that the first session sets up the reality that there are core human needs. If there's anything we ever need to relate to, it's human needs that will affect our psychology, will affect, of course, our physiology, our propensities, across the entire spectrum of human behavior and disease. And that's exactly what this is about. It's about making a society that actually caters to human needs, not where you have to distort yourself in order to participate, which is exactly what we do now. But in the end, just as a final point, the nature of the breakdown, this system's not going to be around for that much longer, one way or another. The question is, what are we really fighting for in the basic sense is, what will the new paradigm be? That is what's going to happen. We have sickness, the denial and sickness of those that are really in control of things have to be overcome in some fashion. I certainly never advocate violence or anything like, but we can only hope the rationale of the breakdown, as at the very end, remember, if you remember from Zeitgeist, the end of those that follow the series, the consciousness I is the oldest symbol of consciousness that there ever is. And it occurs with the fictional central banker. And that's the hope, is that the people that really are in control will finally wake up and understand that it's in their self-interest and for their family and for their kids and their grandkids to stop this bullshit known as modern society today. It really blows your mind and really expresses what we're doing today. I walk around like I just feel absolutely insane when I interact and walk down the street. I'm looking at what the hell's going on. I'm like, damn, I
just walk around
as homeless
people. We walk around as homeless people on the way here. We're scared to walk around. We want to get a cab because we don't want to walk home. Like, that's a problem. You should be able to walk around without feeling scared. You know? We're getting a cab and we're home so you don't get drunk.
I'm going to save my questions because I think it's unfair. You know, it's they want to ask you questions. I can always call you up and we can have vegan lunch and we can. I can ask you all my questions and we can have a vegan outing. And so it's all good.
Can we kill the ugly screen? I've got some intended to be seen. By the way, I apologize for the weird kind of.
That's fine.
Well, there's some weird blurry stuff that happened during the film that was not supposed to be there. I'm only kind of go back and figure out what that was. I'm sure most of you didn't. Notice the fact that it was weird color issues. I don't know.
Sorry,
I'm being critical.
Just a question. So, the way we're going to do it is we have microphones set up on either side. Please make your way to the microphone. We're trying to keep it no more than five people deep at those microphones. And, Peter will be more than joyful to answer your questions, but please keep your questions short. And to the point, and make sure you have one before you get up there.
In my experience with these Q&As is that there's a tendency for people to want to pontificate a little bit when they ask the question. They actually will preface their question with a long treatment. Please don't do that. Because as everyone else wants to ask a question, and we don't have much time here
today. Exactly.
So just ask a straightforward question. I really appreciate that.
Yes, and the last time we did a Q&A with Peter, it was like a 3-hour Q&A. No one wanted to leave, so we want to give time for everyone to be able to ask questions. Before we start with the first question, what I really loved about the